In the previous example, both Pepsi and Coke will be tempted to lower their prices, and they both end up earning a lower profit of $8 million instead of $10 million. So that's a collusion rather than a competing with each other where it benefited them both. Yet both will be tempted to cheat and cut prices. And this is known as the prisoner's dilemma, where two or more firms, by attempting to individually choose the best strategy for them, actually chooses the worst option, well, than if they had cooperated in the first place. You see this prisoner's dilemma occur a lot in real life. Whenever you go, you know, think about the damn, we should have cooperated in the first place instead of fighting. You know, this kind of thing happens. It's a prisoner's dilemma. So, for example, when people go to some public event, such as a concert or a match, a football match, for example, they often stand up in order to get a better view. But when everyone starts standing up, everyone else starts standing up. After all, if they say sitting down, they will not see anything at all. In this equilibrium, most people are worse off because except for the tall people, maybe like me, no, their view is likely to be worse and they lose the comfort of sitting down. Another example is when firms spend a lot of money on advertising. So if they are aggressive and they do a lot of advertising to get ahead of their rivals, they can do that. If they're cautious as well, they do a lot of advertising too, just in case their rivals do advertising. But although in both cases, even though the individual firm's best interests are to do advertising, the resulting Nash equilibrium is likely to be one of excessive advertising, and the total advertising spend on firms is wastage. It is not recouped in the additional sales because they're all just fighting each other. Instead, why not just everybody, no, don't do any advertising at all, and they might just actually save a lot of money.